Good morning. It is Thursday, November 7th, and welcome to Bleed Green News. I'm Sharon Nelson.
And I'm McKenna Hall. If you have not turned in your federal cards, please do so as soon as possible.
There's still time for you to pre-order your Christmas trees and wreaths from CCHS track and field athletes. If you would like to order, please contact a track athlete or email Coach Listard or Coach Slider.
The FAFSA applications for federal student aid form to apply for financial aid for college is open for all seniors online. Some states and schools have limited funds, so don't delay.
The next ACT will be Saturday, December 14th. Registration deadlines is November 8th. Future test dates are February 8th and April 4th of next year.
CCHS Theater Classes presents Arsenic and Old Lace by Joseph Kingserling, November 21st through the 23rd at 7 p.m. in the CCHS Theater. General admission is $5, CCHS students is $4, senior citizens and younger students is only $3.
The Regeneron Science Talent Search 2020 application is now open. High school seniors across the United States are invited to share their original research projects and apply to the finest STEM competitions in the nation. The application will close this Wednesday, November 13th at 8 p.m. Eastern Time.
Please do not use your Chromebook to charge your other devices. The devices pull more amps than the Chromebook can provide.
Shaley Small interviewed Mr. Marsh about the Japanese language class offered here at CCHS. Here it is.
I absolutely love it, obviously, because I've been doing it now for 15 years. It was about 16 years ago that I had it, or at least had the opportunity to start it here at the high school. And we actually had some excess monies, believe it or not, in schools today having excess money. But they were going to bring in four new electives, and they asked the students, and PE football, I think, got the number one votes with as many people that play football, and then Japanese got the number two amount of votes, and so I put together a curriculum and have been teaching it ever since. Well, if you look at what you can do with Japanese so far as electronics, cars, business in Asia, which has well over one-fourth of the world's population, Japan is the doorway into Asia at this time. Plus, right now, Asia itself is booming, but the Japanese population is actually declining. They're having more deaths than they have births. And so this year, they just reached 2.4 million new workers from foreign countries to come work. And in the next 15 years, that's expected to get even bigger. So the job market is going to be there. Plus, you get paid the same, if not better, than you do at American companies. Plus, you get better insurance. Well, I look at Japanese from a couple different ways. I can teach it like a language teacher, like it's a language, but being a math and science guy too, I've broken it down so it's kind of like an equation you might learn in algebra. If you do this plus this plus this, you get an equation, or in my case, if you put this and this and this together, you get yourself a sentence. And so I've done that. I also give them plenty of time to start learning, since it's a logographic language, meaning they have symbols instead of letters. We use a whole first quarter to work on that, and we constantly use that. Another thing is this year I actually developed my own booklets to go with it to do some pre-teaching so that the students can have a basis. So when we do hit the book, they'll understand and have a little bit better recognition of what we're doing. And so I've done a number of things. Plus, I take every about 2 to 3 years a group to Japan. And so that makes Japanese just as interesting as anything else.
Thank you, Shaylee and Mr. Marsh, for that interview.
In sports, our number one ranked varsity football team will play Spring Creek this Friday in the second round of the Northern 3A playoffs. Meanwhile, the second seeded Fernley Vaqueros will play the Truckee Wolverines this Friday, and the winner advances to the Northern 3A championship games.
Our girls volleyball team will play Fernley Friday at 6:45 at Truckee High School in the first round of the Northern 3A volleyball playoffs. The girls finished the regular season in sixth place in league play.
Congratulations to Savannah Wrigley, who qualified for Nevada State 3A Cross Country Championship meet in Reno this Saturday. Good luck to all our athletes and teams.
Tryouts for high school girls basketball will be Saturday, November 16th from 8 a.m. to 10, and Monday, November 18th from 3 p.m. to 5:30. You cannot try out unless you have registered online at registermyathlete.com.
That's all for today. Thanks for watching Bleed Green News. I'm Cheyenne Nelson.
And I'm McKenna Hall.
Have a great day.